Sometimes we don't understand that it's more blessed to give than to receive. It's hard for God to give things to us when we have our hands or our mouths of compassion closed. And because this, Pastor Howard, this Babylonian system has influenced us so much, the world, that we don't understand God's kingdom government system. Amen. The kingdom of God, the influence, the impact, so that the kingdom of heaven can come in and take over. Amen. And cause whatever territory incoming through the kingdom of God influence would now reign and rule. So when God tells us to give, he means to give. Amen. Because what we let go, then he can show you that's more he want to get to us. So it's hard for people now where we look at the news on the TV so much. And they'll tell you that the economic climate is real bad right now. So the first thing believers do, Pastor Alton, they start shutting up their pockets and pocketbooks and wallets, and they start holding on to everything tight. Just keep looking straight ahead and nobody know what talking to you. But God said, even in the world family, there's no family to the citizens of the kingdom. You don't see a reason out there. It ain't no showing that. God asks us to give him back the time he's giving us, and sometimes we won't even do that. Hallelujah. But bless the Lord. You know, Peter said in the Bible, Pastor Hamilton, you just getting ready, I'm going to introduce him right in a minute. Peter told Jesus, say, Lord, we left everything to follow you. I believe Jesus told him that wasn't written in the Bible. He said, Peter, hold on, excuse me, wait a minute. You left two catfish in a boat. He said, but any time you give up anything for the kingdom, say it. He said, you'll receive it a hundredfold. Not when you get to heaven, but in the now. Amen, somebody. I'm trying to help somebody right now. Hallelujah. So if you gave up anything for the Lord's sake and you haven't got it back, you better check and see if you really gave it up for the Lord's sake. Amen. Amen. Because if we give anything up for the Lord's purpose, I promise you, he can't lie. He won't lie. Amen. You'll get it back. Amen. 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 I'm waiting for a clap. Somebody to get it. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. You just have to learn more about the kingdom principles. Amen. Amen. Bless the Lord. Amen. Well, we come to preaching time. Hallelujah. For someone that might not know the evangelist, for the first 3 nights, the revivalist, Pastor Earl T. Hamilton, Jr. I will use the 3 E's to introduce him. The first one, I'm sure you already know that he's the esteemed pastor of Little Zion, up in North Road, where God is using him to be the under-shepherd and doing some great things by the Spirit of the living God. Amen. Amen. The people are being blessed. Amen. The community are being blessed. Amen. The neighborhood is being blessed. Amen. The surrounding areas are being blessed. Amen. And the nations are being blessed. Amen. So we understand that he's the esteemed pastor of Little Zion, the son of Eve, he's an educated man. But I believe Pastor Howerton will tell you just like Paul before he had that conversion on the Damascus Road when he was of the Pharisees. He said what he had gained, he counted loss. Amen. He counted as dumb that he might know the excellence of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So we know he's an educated man. And now we're going to do the last. He is the evangelist for the first three nights. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's a family man. If I'm correct, I think the Lord just raised him with his son. They are son and sibling. These are them. Amen. 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 Lovely wife, Sister Hamilton. Amen. First Lady Howerton, we're just so thankful for God sending them in the area. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I'll present to some and introduce to others the evangelist for the first three nights, the esteemed pastor of Little Zion Baptist Church in Oak Grove, Pastor Earl T. Howerton, Jr. Hear ye what the Lord has to say through the man of God tonight. We ask the Lord Gospel Course who has been blessing us to give us another song, and then we're going to hear what thus saith the Lord. Amen.